Across America and around the world, once again, you're listening to The Hour of the Time. I'm William Cooper.
And I'm Carolyn Nelson.
And on the phone from Phoenix, Arizona, we have... We have a whole lot of screw-ups is what we have. Oh, this is fun. Gene Miller with the Metal Report from Swiss America Trading. Welcome to the Hour of the Time.
Well, good evening. How are y'all doing?
We're having some fun here with the buttons again.
Yeah, gremlins, huh?
Yeah, sounds like you got a bad connection there, Gene.
Correct.
Yeah.
A lot of static. Well, you're coming in crystal clear, so I don't know exactly what the problem is, but as far as the market goes, everything kind of took a little bit of a hit today. The stock market was down about 6.5 points, closed at 36.77.80. Silver was down about 20 cents. Gold was down about $7.80. All this was primary.
Gene, it just ain't working.
Can't hear me?
No.
Very low.
I've checked the phone lines. I can't find anything loose here. You want to try and call again?
I'll call back in.
Okay, everybody else, please stay off the line so we can get our Monday night and metal report. Oh, boy. Well, you see, folks, I was just away for a weekend and kept hitting the wrong button 3 times. That's a lot of fun. How many of you listen to Larry King tonight? We're going to talk about that a little bit later. But right now, keep the phones clear so that Gene Miller can try and dial in again. If he can dial in again, I hope. Anyway, he should be trying right now. I hope he's trying to find another phone. Here's a book that all of you should read. It's called Toward a Human World Order. Toward a Human World Order. I want you all to run out and find this book, Toward a Human World Order, by Gerald and Patricia Misch, M-I-S-C-H-E. It's called Toward a Human World Order by Gerald and Patricia Misch, M-I-S-C-H-E. It's published by the Paulist Press, and the copyright is 1977. Hello, is that Eugene?
Yeah.
Okay.
Is that any better?
Not much.
Oh.
I don't know what's going on. You want to give it a try?
Try it.
Well, we can give her a shot here.
Why don't you go ahead and talk, and I'll run around and see if I can find something here.
Okay, well, the gold closed down about $7.80 today. Silver was down 20 cents, and the stock market was down $6.15. All this was primarily the oil prices taking a beating today. And then the initial estimates of what happens every year. Somehow they always say that at the beginning of the Christmas season that the shopping is going to be better than next year, but then by the time Christmas ends up, they always say it's the worst. So just the markets reacted to that today, and I think that we'll quickly see an adjustment with that in the gold and silver moving back up. This does, you got to keep in mind, though, the discount, the real news that's out there that our country country is rapidly in debt and is just rapidly getting farther in that position. So one day of news in one direction doesn't wipe out the years of bad management that we've had going on. I checked with Gannett stock, and that's up a dollar, closed at 55 3/4.
It's also kind of interesting. In the last 52 weeks, the high had been 55.5. So actually, what's happening in that with the people buying is actually reaching all new highs in it. So that's good news.
Well, we got it fixed.
Yeah. Found out what it was.
I don't know what it was. I just jiggled wires, and then all of a sudden, there it was.
Okay.
So somebody taught me a long time ago, if you don't know what you're doing, jiggle some wires, and that's what
wires,
I did.
Yeah, there we go. We had a great response on the 67 Morgans that we offered the other night. In fact, there is none available. And there's still a great buy. In fact, what's going on with the Gannett stock is the same thing what we're doing with the 67 Morgans, 67, 66 piece dollars. We're riding that market up, and we're actually pushing it up. And the sole purpose, as I've told before, and I tell people every time that they call in, don't fall in love with this stuff. We're using this for one purpose only, and that's to go back in and end up owning a lot more bullion, the bullion silver, bullion gold, the things that I think that are really going to be of value, or the very low-end numismatic, the things that are going to do you the best good when this thing finally does unravel. If you're interested in some 67 Morgans, give me a call. Either call me tonight or call me tomorrow. At this point, all I can do is put you on a waiting list. And basically, it'll be first come, first serve. As one comes in, we'll call you. If you're interested, it's yours. If you're not, it's a pass or play type of deal. But if you are interested, I would, by all means, suggest at least come on a waiting list so that you can get them in the opportunity. The other thing I wanted to share tonight was get a lot of questions about, and especially with the end of the year, IRA money. With all the listeners that we have out there, there are thousands of people that at one time or another put themselves into an IRA, which I believe is unfortunate, but nonetheless, at the time they probably didn't know better. I got a client that I talked to today trying to get her money out, and I mean, they are making her jump through all kinds of hoops. But the question is, what do I do with IRA money? Well, there's two things you can consider doing. There is a way that you can transfer your IRA money dollar for dollar into gold bullion without facing a penalty and without paying any tax right at this point. It'd take me a little longer than what would allow me on the radio tonight to explain it, so call me tomorrow. Call Swiss America, 1-800-289-2646. And we'll explain how that works, see if it's viable to you, see if it's something you'd want to do. The only other option is, and I tell people, you're going to pay taxes one way or the other on it, as far as the government is concerned. And the way Slick Willie's going, you're going to pay higher taxes. You may even want to consider getting it out of there, because when this whole thing does collapse, whatever is left in that, I believe you're going to lose, So, something to consider, but there is a way to transfer it into gold and gold bullion, even at this point, and get around it, so I can give you the details on that and then even send you out some information.
Well, that sounds good. What do you foresee for the next few days?
Well, finish up this month. I think that the people are just going to kind of watch and see what's going on. The Christmas shopping will have an effect on the market, believe it or not. I think that end of the month, people are getting, will kind of finish up their tax base and, kind of get their end of the year affairs in order. Generally, just traditionally, if past year's experience or any indication, the December usually causes a rally in the gold market. People are repositioning their funds before the end of the year. And so, again, I would encourage people that are considering doing something, making a move, do it before the end of the year, before you enter into a new tax year in 1994. That would be my, recommendation at this point.
Well, that sounds like good advice to me, and we thank you for giving us the metals report on this Monday night, and I apologize to you, Gene, and for everybody else for whatever it was that was wrong. I'll probably be here most of the morning tomorrow trying to track it down so it doesn't happen again.
You have a good evening.
Thank you, Gene. Good night.
Good night.
Now, for those of you who didn't get the number, it's 1-800-289-2646. That's 1-800-289-2646. As for Gene Miller, mention my name, William Cooper. Thank them for sponsoring this program, The Hour of the Time. And be sure and ask for all the free newsletters because they're chock full of information that you need to know. I hope you all had a wonderful weekend, and I hope you're ready for the week. Remember what I told you at the beginning of our stock purchase deal, our go for the guns, our purchase of Gannett Company Incorporated so that we can regain control of the media? Well, when we first began talking about it, in fact, that very night, the price was 50 and a quarter, I believe. And then when we began buying stock, it went up to around 51 and hovered around 51, 51 and a quarter, 51 and a half, 51 and three quarters, back down to 51. Today, at 4 p.m., the price of Gannett Company Incorporated stock was 55 and three quarters. All these other market fluctuations are not disturbing Gannett because of the pressure that we are exerting upon that stock. If you haven't purchased the stock yet, get off your lazy butt and do it now before you have to fork out $100 a share, dummies. You've all been asking me for years, what can we do? I give you a plan that we can do, and you're still sitting on your butts. The initial surge of stock buying and the letters we've received containing copies of stock certificates and proxies are slacking off, which means you guys are slacking off. You're not doing your job. You're not presenting this plan to your churches and to your organizations and to the people in your town. You're not calling your local talk show hosts. This is our chance, ladies and gentlemen. Most people don't know anything about it. You must help me spread the word. You see, if you don't jump on this bandwagon, you better not ever in your life ask me what you can do. Because you won't like what I'm going to tell you. I can guarantee you right now. The pressure we put on Gannett Company Incorporated stock drove it up to 56 and a quarter today, ladies and gentlemen. 56 and a quarter. 492,700 shares were traded today. The yield is 2.3. Price to earnings ratio is 21 to 1. Now, let me give you the updated information on Gannett Company Incorporated. And this comes, in fact, this is brand new. This is something that you haven't heard before. Gannett is growing, folks, because USA Today, founded in 1982, passed the Wall Street Journal in circulation and became the nation's largest newspaper. An expensive startup, the paper is close to marking its first profit after $700 million in losses over 10 years. And with 82 daily newspapers and more than 50 non-daily publications and an average daily circulation of over 6.3 million for all of its dailies, Gannett, the largest United States newspaper group, is the proverbial gorilla that can sit anywhere it wants to. Gannett ranks number one in revenues among newspaper companies. Now, if you doubted the intelligence work of CAGI, the Citizens Agency Joint Intelligence, if we don't know what we're doing, how come we picked the very best media corporation in this country? At the time we picked it, it wasn't number one. It is now. We knew it would be. Gannett also owns 10 TV stations, 15 radio stations, and North America's largest outdoor advertising company. Other ventures include online, radio and telephone information services, Gannett News Service, USA Today, Sky Radio, news and entertainment for airlines, direct marketing and telemarketing companies, a printing company, and the Lewis Harris and Associates polling company. See, if we get control of this corporation, we can play the same games the other side does. Yes, sir, we can. Only to win, all we have to do is print the truth instead of the lies. After sliding for 2 years, earnings started to climb in 1992. Advertising-based businesses have had hard times since 1991 because of economic recession. In 1993, Gannett completed the purchase of the Honolulu Advertiser, a morning paper, and the city's largest daily. At the same time, it sold the afternoon Honolulu Star Bulletin, but the papers did not end their 1962 joint operating agreement, which means they're still together. The Gannett Company started, folks, in 1906 in Elmira, New York, when Frank Gannett and his associates purchased a half interest in the Elmira Gazette. The small company expanded slowly, purchasing two additional newspapers by 1912. In 1918, the company moved to Rochester, where it acquired two more newspapers. And in 1923, Gannett, having bought out his associates' interests, formed the Gannett Company. In 1929, Frank Gannett co-invented the teletype setter. Gannett continued to buy small and medium-sized dailies in the Northeast, and by 1947, the company operated 21 newspapers and 7 radio stations. At the time of his death in 1957, Frank Gannett had accumulated 30 newspapers. During the 1960s, Gannett continued buying local newspapers, expanding to become a national newspaper chain. It was not until 1966, however, that Gannett started its own newspaper, Today, in Cocoa Beach, Florida, and Gannett went public in 1967. The company went through its greatest expansion during the 1970s and 1980s under the direction of Alan Newhart, who became CEO in 1973 and chairman in 1979. Gannett captured national attention in 1979 when it merged with Phoenix-based Combined Communications Corporation, CCC, another media conglomerate whose holdings included TV and radio stations, an outdoor advertising business, which is the second largest in the United States, the Lewis Harris polling business, and the Cincinnati Inquirer and Oakland Tribune. Gannett's revenues passed the $1 billion mark in 1979. In 1982, Gannett started USA Today, a national newspaper whose splashy format and short articles made it an industry novelty. Gannett's largest acquisition came in 1986 when it bought the Evening News Association for $717 million, gaining 5 more newspapers, including the Detroit News and 2 TV stations. The Detroit News entered into a joint operating agreement with the Detroit Free Press in 1989. Despite high hopes, the Detroit News remains unprofitable. Newhart retired as chairman of Gannett in 1989. During his 16-year tenure as the company's leader, the outspoken Newhart spent approximately $1.5 billion on acquisitions and increased the combined circulation of Gannett's newspapers to 6.3 million. In 1990, Gannett's string of 89 consecutive quarters of earnings gains was broken. In 1991, Gannett launched USA Today, Baseball Weekly, a tabloid with statistics, schedules, and TV previews. In the same year, the company sold 5 Washington, D.C. area newspapers to comply with FCC rules, and after absorbing cumulative losses of $100 million, sold the assets of Little Rock, Arkansas Gazette to the Arkansas Democrat. News 2000, begun in 1991, contacted more than 100,000 readers in its first 18 months in an attempt to find out what they want in news content and formats. USA Today On Demand, a fax service for such information as corporate earnings and news, began in 1992. Gannett New Media planned to provide online access to USA Today in 1993. New York Stock Exchange symbol, folks, is GCI. Stockholders meeting is May 4th. And could go on and on and on and on, but there's really no point in that. So we got lots to talk about tonight, folks. So let's go to the phones and see who's there. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Bill. It's Ken from Oak Park, Illinois. And I wrote a letter to Ken Jernigan, the former executive director of the National Federation of Mine, telling him about Gannett's stock. And so I hope you'll, someone will publish it in the Braille Monitor and spread the word, because, you know, spreading the word that way.
Good. That's wonderful.
That. And I have someone look in my mail tomorrow and see if I can find my, voting.
Your proxy.
Your proxy, you know, so I can then, get it back to you.
If you can't find a proxy, send me a power of attorney to vote your stock.
Send me a power of attorney, okay.
Yep. That'll work, too.
Find that at a bank, you know.
Member's got to be signed and notarized.
Okay, then. Thanks.
You're welcome, Ken. Thanks for calling.
Bye-bye.
Number 602-333-2174, folks. You think the police are really on our side, ladies and gentlemen? Have you ever heard of the Fraternal Order of Police? The Fraternal Order of Police? The Fraternal Order of Police? Have you? Have you ever seen their emblem? It's a circle representing the sun with a five-pointed star in the middle. On the left arm is F. Over the top point is O. The right arm is P. Under the left leg is the all-seeing eye. And under the right leg is the grip of the Master Mason. The Fraternal Order of Police. We've been had, ladies and gentlemen. Rolling Rock Beer now mentions the New World Order in their commercials. Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, Bill.
Hi.
This is Paul from Washington State, a recent new listener, and I picked you up after Gary Bourgeois' show there on one of the Friday nights here not too long ago, and just calling in and let you know you got a listener here, and I'd like to have you keep up the good work. I've been aware of the Freemason conspiracy for quite a number of years. Are you familiar with the...
Oh, I thought they were just a benevolent fraternal order existing for the good of the community.
Yeah, that's right. that's what they say in their literature. I haven't heard you mention... do you know who Helen Peters was?
Name doesn't ring a bell.
She had an organization. It was back in late 60s, early... She passed away in about April of 71. She was located in Michigan, and she had an organization called Defenders of the USA Republic. And she put out a lot of information on the Freemasons and so forth.
Okay.
And
you know, you've got to put your mouth right in front of your phone, and you got to talk louder.
Okay, I'll...
That's much better.
Okay, great. And does anybody know what transponder you're going to be moving to?
Nope.
I understand you're still going to be on SpaceNet 3.
Well, we don't know that for sure. That's the rumor.
Anyway, I heard Blair...
we don't even know if we're going to have a satellite tomorrow night.
Okay, well...
we're just going to take it night by night and see what happens.
I did hear one or two of the tapes on... a few nights ago, and the AIDS tape was supposed to be coming up shortly. Is that going to be going to be playing that soon?
If we broadcast it.
Pardon me?
If we broadcast it.
Okay.
Okay. I have some serious problems with some of the things in the next two tapes in that series. I might play them with a disclaimer, and I might not. I think it's got some good points. I think it's got some points that. But according to our investigations, have no merit whatsoever. But I'll tell you this, Alex Loglia does good research, and the last three shows that he's done have been just outstanding that he's done for us. But this AIDS thing has got everybody confused, and nobody really knows what's going on with it.
There's a lot of disinformation out there.
There sure is, and it's easy to get trapped in that loop. And I'm not saying that that's where Alex Loglia is. We may be trapped in that loop, but what I'm saying is there's some things that we as a group, CAGI, has some serious questions about.
Well, put it out with a disclaimer, and then let's...
Yeah, we may do that, because the real purpose of the show is to air information that cannot be heard anywhere else, and caution everybody to begin using their own brains.
Well, we're not going to be able to hear that on the radio station here in Seattle, Washington, so...
Since you're a new listener, I could add that Alex has put out a tape called Vaccinations. You might want to hear it.
Okay.
Did you catch that?
Yes, I think I picked up the address when you broadcast that last tape, so... I'll write to him and see if I can get that.
Okay, I want to thank you for calling.
Okay, I thank you too.
Good night.
Bye.
602-333-2174. I'm sorry, folks. I'm making mistakes all over the place, but I got so much on my mind. Did any of you watch Larry King tonight? If you did, I want to talk about that. Good evening. You're on the air.
Yes. Hello, Will. This is... Bruce from New York calling.
Hi, Bruce. Did you watch Larry King tonight?
No, I didn't. I listened to a very interesting program on the radio the other night, and there was a radio program about aliens, and that they're going to be landing at the White House lawn in 1994.
Yeah, what do you think?
Well, I think something's going to happen in 1994.
Why?
Why
1994? Things have been happening for years. We've already lost the Bill of Rights, and everybody's talking about aliens landing on the White House lawn in 1994.
Right.
I don't understand that. Where's the priority? Where's your priorities?
Well, I'm just, you know, I just think that falls into what you talk about, that they're going to use this, they're going to use the...
Now you're talking.
What?
I said, now you're talking sense.
Yeah, they're going to use these aliens to bring us into the One World Order.
Yeah, I think that's exactly right. Whether they're real or whether they're not real, this is going to be used to break down the sovereignty of nations and convince everybody that because they're out there and they're technologically superior to us, we must all come together as one humanity in one world, and we must combine all of our forces, and we must create one government to protect us from this threat from outer space. And even if they come down and kiss our feet and claim that they came to rescue us and teach us great wisdom, they will still represent a threat simply for the reason that they got here before we got there.
Right on.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Thank you. Thank you for calling. Let me see here. Larry King Live. Yes. Larry King Live, folks, tonight talked about something that's happening in Canada. There is a murder trial. A murder trial going on. And the judge has censored all of the press. One judge in Canada has prohibited all of the press in the entire country of Canada from covering this trial, from reporting on it, from anything. Larry King Live opened up his show with, "Should the press be censored?" and then proceeded to tell the listening audience that he himself was going to censor what was said on his program because of the Canadian judge's order. Guess what, folks? This is the next step in the suppression of freedom in the United States of America, that because we are the neighbors of Canada, if a Canadian judge orders that the press cannot cover something, then as a good neighbor, we have to honor that judge's order, and I say, cock a del toro, Mr. Judge. This is the United States of America. And the reason we have a full free press here is to prevent the king or the government or the judge from trying somebody in secret so that the public won't know if they're being railroaded or if they're really innocent. It's to keep people from disappearing in the middle of the night with no trial. I want to talk about this, folks. This is important. And Larry King, being a member of the press and censoring your broadcast in the United States of America, was absolutely, in my estimation, treasonous, despicable. It is not in the best interest of the United States of America, the Constitution, or the Bill of Rights. And if we can get hold of the true facts of what's going on in that trial, I will air it on this broadcast. I don't give a damn what the Canadian judge said. And we've got to take a break, folks. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Yeah, I don't know how many of you people were watching the Larry King show, but on that show they had a representative of Canadian Broadcast Network, a lawyer actually, and he represented the non-suppression of the press side, and then they had another guy who said that the judge was right, and Larry King is acting like he doesn't know what's right or wrong. Have you ever read the Constitution, Larry King? You've always been a front man for the New World Order, and we're getting a little bit sick and tired of your bullshit. This is really bad. When we have a representation of this type, and we have American media people, there was a man from a television station in Buffalo, New York, and they were debating whether or not they could broadcast the story of the trial, not knowing what legal repercussions could come back on the television station in the United States of America. And they were actually saying that the country of Canada could prosecute American journalists if they published this story. Now, you mark my words, this is going to become a major issue, and this is going to result in the suppression of the press in the United States of America. It's already happened. Good evening. You're on the air.
Yes, Mr. Cooper.
Yes.
Congratulations for opening my mind to the New World Order. I've been listening to your show since you started there, and I think it was October of last year, was it?
Actually, it was May the 4th, 1992.
Oh, that's... Well, anyway, I kind of had Larry King pegged there. I notice all these triangles that are starting to appear now on these TV programs.
Oh, yes.
Jeopardy, and even in advertisements, it's getting right out of hand here.
The symbology is everywhere.
Isn't that something, though?
Yes, it is.
But they're not even trying to any longer.
Yeah.
Also, if you didn't hear me the other night, folks, when I outed Pat Buchanan, we just discovered Pat Buchanan is a member of the Sovereign and Military Order of the Knights of Malta. That's why he doesn't really talk about the Federal Reserve. That's why he really doesn't talk about the secret societies. That's why he pretends to be a conservative, just like Mr. Buckley and Mr. Perot and all the rest of these creepos. Well, what can we do for you?
Well, I haven't...
Did you see Larry King tonight?
I didn't see Larry King, no. As a matter of fact, I would probably watch that, but I don't get those stations here. The whole thing of it is that I can see what's going on with this New World Order and how it's accelerating, especially with some of these gun control laws. And it seems to me that they have a hand in just about everything. Now, I've seen Masons in the public school systems over here. And it seems to me that what they're trying to do, I'd like to know your opinion. What is this new age religion or whatever they're trying to impose by putting these children that might be from a so-called dysfunctional family or whatever on these Ritalin-like drugs. And
now, what do you think the purpose is?
Well, I think they just want to push the button and let them be in a daze all day or something and gain control of their minds.
That's right. They want to destroy their minds. They want to bring them all down to the lowest level so that they can't ever challenge the ruling elite. That's what's coming. I want to thank you for calling, and let's try to get someone out there who's listened to Larry King tonight. I really want to talk about this. I'm really angry about it. I think we need to air this. I think it needs to get out. I think people need to understand what's happening. And I want all you CADGI members out there to get on this story. I want the facts of that trial, and I want them quick, and I'm going to air them. And I'm going to probably be the only one in this country that's going to do it. But I want to air it. And that judge can stick it where the sun don't shine. This is the United States of America. We're a free people with a free press guaranteed by the first article and amendment to the Constitution. Good evening. You're on the air.
Yeah, Mr. Cooper?
Yes?
I'd like to ask two questions. Last week when you were talking about the Kennedy assassination, whatever happened to Bill Greer, where is he now?
I have no idea.
Because I heard on some show that he's going around the country promoting things. Talking.
We can't find him. All we find is we're told that he died in 1985 of some disease.
And also on KDON or out of Las Vegas last night, there was a Richard Hoagland on.
Yeah.
Who made these claims about Mars, that they're covering up the pyramids on Mars.
Yeah. How does he know?
He sounded, out of all of those people, he sounded very convincing.
How does he know?
I don't know. He was just giving a lot of evidence, you know, but he sounded very convincing. I wouldn't.
He must not have given any evidence because you don't know what it is.
Well, I don't remember specifically, but, you know, if anyone else heard it, because it goes over the whole West, maybe they'll remember it better, but yeah. It really sounded convincing.
Let me tell you how he knows.
Always a religious angle to these UFO things. They always use it against.
What does he say is on Mars?
He says that the pyramids that are in Egypt and all that.
That's right. And what are the pyramids?
The New Age.
Temples of Initiation of the Mystery School.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and all these conversations with these talks about UFOs, they always come around to the religions have to change.
Well, that's right. Yeah, they have to get rid of the world's traditional religions. They have to destroy Christianity or they can't have their New World Order.
I'm very surprised that Art Bell, who's really gone into big time, is involved in this. Have you noticed how his show has grown?
Sure. Go follow him when he gets off of work every night, and eventually he'll lead you right straight down to the Masonic Temple, and you might meet John Lear, Bobo Gritz, and Bob Lazar there.
Okay, thanks a lot.
You're welcome. 602-333-2174. I hope that you've... Well, we'll find out. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, good evening. My name is Stan. I'm calling from Ontario, Canada. I'm a CADGI member.
Hi, Stan.
I'm calling actually from the area where the court case actually happened.
Good.
One of the girls was kidnapped just around the corner from my house.
Uh-huh. You know that they were stopping people on the border entering Canada and taking newspapers away from them?
Yeah, it was crazy. Crazy. I agree a little bit with the ban in my area, but I can't believe how national it's gone and now how international it's gone. I think it's crazy. I really know the in-depth stories of the situation, and I can see a local ban because the trial is still going on. But, I mean, to...
Well, you know, I believe that people should have their own country, make their own laws, and whatever their laws are in their country, if they agree with that, that's fine with me. But
yeah.
They're threatening American journalists, and we have the freedom of press in this country, and I'm not going to stand for it.
Oh, yeah, I totally agree with you, but it's just I was watching Larry King, and there was so much being bleeped out. I didn't realize that was happening also in the States.
There's only one reason why someone would air a TV show and then black out the voices so that you can't hear what they're saying, and that's they're trying to make a political point.
Oh, yeah, they're setting all these new precedents, and...
That's right. They're setting the American people up for a fall.
Yeah, but I really have to appreciate the work you do. It's been a pleasure being a member of CADGI, and I hope we can one day take control of Ganymede and make some real changes.
Well, if everybody has to get out there and realize what we're doing, and this is their last chance. Damn it, this is your last chance, people. Don't you understand this? You better get on the ball, because... I tell you, you got no excuses if you don't get on the ball with this.
Oh yeah, people should really pay attention to what's going on in Canada, because we are just sinking in socialism. It's unbelievable.
Right. That's right. And you just can't possibly come up with a better idea than Gannett.
And it's just getting just ridiculous. I hope people really wake up out there.
Well, thank you for calling.
Hey, okay, have a good night.
You too. Bye bye. 602-333-2174. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi. Good evening, Bill. How are you?
Fine. I'm fine. I'm really fine. I'm so worked up. I'm pushing the wrong button. I'm really angry about this. I mean, I sat down. I had a complete different show planned for tonight. I sat down and watched Larry King live, and I just became livid with rage.
Well, you sound suitably irritated. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I wanted to know if you could, this is Dave from Cuyahoga County in Ohio.
Uh-huh.
I want to know if you could please review the strategy with the Gannett. There's myself and a few other people in this area that are interested in knowing more about it. And also, could you take just a moment and review CAGI and tell us what we can do to join, because you're doing a good job. We need to get with you.
Thank you very much, and we need all the help we can get. I'd be happy to. Gannett is well, I just read you everything that you need to know about Gannett. What we want to do is take the media back. We've been presented with so many lies and half-truths and innuendo and this Marxist, liberal, leftist slant, and I'm not a Rush Limbaugh, don't get me wrong, but I know what socialism and Marxism can do to a country and to a people. And all you have to do is look back through history to see it. Look at Canada now. Look at Great Britain. It used to rule the world, and they're just rolling in socialism. And the people are so unhappy. I went to London. I couldn't believe it. Everything I'd read about this great country, it was just blah nothing. The people were not happy. Nobody was smiling. I guess if you went up to the castle, it'd be a different story. But
I lived in Great Britain for 2 years, and most of the people that I met were on the dole or knew somebody who was. It was just horrible.
That's right.
No hope.
And no hope. Socialism takes all hope from you. Takes everything from you. Takes your sustenance. It takes your self-respect. It takes your dignity. It takes everything. But we want to buy at least a major portion of the media so that we can present the real truth to the American people. And we know the truth is elusive, but we would not allow any slant to the news whatsoever. Strictly reported as what happened, and everything would be reported. We want to teach the people to think on their own again and not listen to what somebody else says they're supposed to think. We want to get rid of this political correct baloney that they're spouting out there. I came up with a plan late one night and what to do. You see, in this country, everything's for sale. I don't care what it is. Everything is for sale. And if you believe that one group owns one thing, all you have to do is buy it away from them, because they're people like everybody else, and they're greedy like everybody else.
Right. Bill, I believe somebody just bought the satellite from... whoever.
Yeah, that's right.
Catherine Graham?
Well, they didn't buy the satellite. They bought one channel.
One transponder.
The channel that we were on. And that was Post Newsweek. Catherine Graham bought this channel to shut us up. But it doesn't work, because we're gonna keep on broadcasting in another way. If we buy Gannett Company Incorporated, we'll have a whole bunch of radio stations all over the country in major markets, a whole bunch of TV stations, a whole bunch of newspapers. The biggest outdoor billboard advertising company in the country, and a whole bunch of other things with which to present the real truth to the American people. Also, we'll make sure that all of this suppressed information and the suppressed news that nobody ever hears will get printed, and not with all the slant like you get in the racial slant that you get in the spotlight, and the National Socialist viewpoint that you get from the spotlight, which is headed by Nazis, to tell you the truth.
And then I found that the National Educator has Bo Gritz as a correspondent.
So what we're asking people to do is buy 5 to 10 shares of GCI, Gannett Company Incorporated, initially. If you can't buy that much, if you can't afford that much, buy 1, 2, or 3. But the point is to buy it, and to set aside a program to buy more stock, 1 or 2 or 3 or 5 shares, however many you can afford, every month or every other month, and continue to do that. And as people understand what we're doing, and if you all will help and get off your dead rear ends and get out there and tell everybody what we're doing and how it's going to work and how it's going to help us take this country back, we're going to buy Gannett Company Incorporated, and we're going to turn this country around. And when all these lies come out of the socialist camp, we'll print the truth. And the American people do have a brain. They're not used to using it. But if they see the truth next to the lie, they will begin to catch on. Right now, all they see is the lie. So they never know what the truth is. And what we need
evident.
You to... Pardon?
The truth is self-evident.
That's right. And what we need you to do, once you've done that, is send us a proxy giving me the sole power to vote your stock in perpetuity, the stock that you now own or ever will own, until you rescind it in writing, and then we'll be happy to return your proxy. If you can't get a proxy statement, then send us a power of attorney. And remember, a power of attorney has to be signed and notarized. And all I don't want anything else. I don't want your stock. I don't want your money. All I want is the power to vote your stock as one big, powerful block. Stockholders own the company. And
that includes the stock that you're buying now and the stock that you'll buy in the future. You should word it that way.
That's correct. So, does that help you?
You bet. It helped us very much.
One more thing. When you write in for your information packet, you can ask for the news release that Bill Cooper has worked up. It's a single page. It gives a bit of information, and it might help you out.
Could you give the address for Cashy again, please?
Yes. P.O. Box 1420, Sholo, spelled S-H-O-W-L-O-W, Arizona, 85901. That's P.O. Box 1420, Sholo, Arizona, 85901. And the way you join CAGI is just write for an info pack, and it'll tell you all about it and what you need to do. And I'll tell you right now that CAGI, these press credentials are really causing us a lot of problems and a great expense. So if you want press credentials with your membership package, you better become a member now, because very shortly we're going to cut out the press credentials and offer them separately at a much higher price, simply because the labor and the problems that are caused by some irresponsible people with these press credentials is just driving the price out of sight. So anyway, that's my advice, and I hope.
Well, thank you very much, Bill. God bless you.
All right, let me add also that you can call in anytime, 1-602-333-5174 to the research office. I'm here pretty much 7 days a week, and you can use the fax number, which is the call-in number that you used tonight to call into the show.
Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Bill.
Hello.
How are you doing? We're calling from Canada this evening.
Wonderful.
Came across a new book, something to do with the New World Order. I don't know if anybody out there has heard about it. It's written by Professor Rudman of Queen's University in Toronto. It's called Bordering on Aggression. And it's about the New World Order and their plans to take over the U.S. and Canada from Russia in the north and Mexico in the south. And it talks about NAFTA and the general plans of NAFTA as being the forerunner to this, and also American expansionism into Canada. Quite an enlightening little book. Also, I had talked to you earlier about a couple other books coming out of Toronto. We're starting to see something about the New World Order here in Canada. Two of them are called The New World Order and The Throne of the Antichrist, and the other one is called The New World Order in America, written by Robert O'Driscoll at the University of Toronto. So these are all just put out here in 93. A lot of good information for people. And that's about all I was going to say.
Okay. We thank you very much for the call. And do you know about this suppression of the press in Canada?
Yes, I do. And actually, I was just reading an article in the Vancouver Sun today how they had been stopping anybody at the border with any more than one copy of newspapers coming out of Detroit and Buffalo concerning that case going on. I haven't been following it too closely, but yes, I've been getting articles about the press putting bans on all kinds of things being put on the press here in Canada. I mean, it's getting worse. It's getting bad. And, of course, you may well know the Reform Party just got into B.C., so we're in big trouble up here.
Yeah, you are. And for all of you in the rest of the world listening, that's what we're all in for.
Yeah. So all we can do is try to educate each other. Wake people up. I know I've been stirring up some trouble in my own community here.
I know you have.
There's an issue, and word seems to be spreading far and wide. But out of all of that has also come what I feel is some good news for people suffering from any kind of mysterious diseases like the Gulf War veterans and so on. It's called Life Crystals, and it's been developed by a nuclear physicist who has his operations in El Paso down in Texas. And Life Crystals seem to be fixing up a lot of problems for people, including AIDS and HIV. He's got a 90-96% cure rate for breast cancer in women. And if anybody wants a phone number to call these people, Life Crystals Incorporated, the phone number is 915-877-4520. I've been researching this fellow for about 8 weeks. I had an interview with him in Vancouver, attended one of his lectures, been looking for any kind of dirt on the man I can find. Can't find anything so far. Have a number of friends taking the Life Crystals, and people seem to be getting healthy. It's building up their immune system where vaccines destroy. And producing some phenomenal results for just about everything going. So, for good news, it's the only thing I've found lately in any of my work.
Okay.
So, not that I'm trying to plug him. He's not out there advertising. He's not promoting. He doesn't want press coverage. He's having troubles with the FDA, trying to close him down there. But you can contact the people in El Paso. They can send you some information. Or I can send information here from Canada. You know, I'm working hard on that lately. So
well, I've got to interrupt you because we've got to move on.
Okay. Well, it's great talking to you, and keep slugging, and we'll be in touch.
Okay. Thank you.
No.
And thank you for that report, folks. Like always, don't believe anything that you hear or read until you check it out in your own research. Now, I want to give you a little idea of what's going on here. This is a quote from a book called In the Coils Are the Coming Conflict. In the Coils Are the Coming Conflict. This book was published in 1882, and I'm reading from page 241. Quote, once a Mason, always a Mason. Once a Mason, everywhere a Mason. However independent, either as individuals or as lodges, whether grand or subordinate, and we are each and all truly free and uncontrolled by anything save our ancient laws and constitution. Yet no Mason can be a foreigner to another Mason. We are all equal citizens of one common government, having equal rights, equal privileges, and equal duties, and in which government, thank God, the majority does not govern. For our order, in its very constitution, strikes at the root of that which is the very basis of popular government. It proclaims and practices not that the will of the masses is wise and good and is such to be obeyed, not that the majority shall govern, but that the law, above mentioned ancient law, shall govern. Our tenet is not only that no single man, but that nobody of men, however wise or numerous, can change in any degree one single landmark of our ancient institution. Our law is strictly organic. It cannot be changed without being destroyed. You may take a man to pieces, and you may take a watch to pieces, but you cannot alter his organs and put him together again as you do the timekeeper. Masonry is the living man, and all other forms of government mere convenient machines made by clever mechanics for regulating the affairs of state. Not only do we know no north, no south, no east, and no west, but we know no government save our own. To every government save that of Masonry, and to each and all alike, we are foreigners. and this form of government is neither pontifical, autocratic, monarchical, republican, democratic, nor despotic. It is a government per se, and that government is Masonic. We have nothing to do with forms of government, forms of religion, or forms of social life. We are a nation of men only bound to each other by Masonic ties as citizens of the world. And that world, the world of Masonry, brethren to each other all the world over, foreigners to all the world beside. The above that I just read, folks, is the compressed essence of Masonic life, and it's taken directly from the Missouri Grand Lodge report for 1867, the same Grand Lodge of which Harry Truman, the man who signed the United Nations Treaty and pushed through Congress the UN Participation Act, was the Grand Master of. How do you like them apples? Good evening, you're on the air.
Bill?
Yes?
I'm calling from Metairie, Louisiana.
Welcome.
Hi. This is my first time calling your show. I've been listening to you off and on for a while now. You're hard to get through to. I don't have any proof of this to give you. I wasn't there, but I talked to two different people. Metairie is right outside New Orleans, if you don't know.
Yes, I do.
Okay.
But we're running out of time, so you got to make it real quick.
They had the Shrine Circus in town last night.
Yes.
And the flag-raising ceremony for the circus. The American flag was raised up with the Canadian and the Mexican flag. I've heard this from two different people. I asked them if they brought a camera. No one did. This was not covered on the news, but I'm going to go ahead and see if we can find out some more details on it.
Yeah, please get some testimony or something. Try to get a photograph. That's the best thing.
That's the best, but nobody brought that camera to the circus. No one expected it. But the Canadian and Mexican flag with the U.S., the lady said it looked like NAFTA. Just thought you'd find that interesting.
Actually, it's Region 1 of the New World Order.
All right, keep it up. Thanks.
You're welcome. And we just about got time for one more real quick call. So whoever's out there that wants to get something in really quick, you've just got a few seconds to do it. So, and nobody's doing it. So good night, folks. God bless each and every single one of you.
Hey, you wake up in the morning. To the table, you see the same old thing. Ain't no food upon the table, there's no fork up in the pan. But you better not complain, boy. You get in trouble with the man.
Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a hell of a loving light on me.
Yonder come his roses, down the world you know. By the way she wears the apron and the clothes she wore, umbrella on her shoulder, piece of paper in her hand. She come to see the governor, she want to free her man.
Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a hell of a loving light on me.
Let the hell
We what?
You said you outed Pat Buchanan?
Added?
You outed Pat Buchanan?
Oh, yeah. He's a member of the Sovereign and Military Order of the Knights of Malta.
Really?
His first allegiance is sworn to the Pope.
That's amazing.
Isn't it? He was running for president. His first allegiance is sworn to the Pope.
Does Casey belong to that? Bill Casey, what's his name?
Bill Casey was a member of the Sovereign and Military Order of the Knights of Malta. So was Wild Bill Donovan.
He was the first director?
Yeah.
Wow, that's amazing. I know Buckley, well, Buckley is a member of...
Buckley's Knights of Malta.
I knew he was Skull and Bones.
He's also Skull and Bones.
That's fantastic. All right, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Hello.
Yeah, Bill?
Yeah.
Well, listen, you've been off the air, in and out for the last 15 minutes.
No, I've been on the air. I've got a radio right in front of me.
We couldn't hear it in Texas.
Yeah, I don't know what to say about that.
It's in and out. Anyhow, it's mind-boggling. Can I have a copy of what you read on the air about the guy up Mason? He's always a Mason.
Sure.
Oh, boy, I would really appreciate it. Can you make a fax of my... You cannot fax nothing.
No, I can't fax this. Just, I'll make a copy of it and just send me a...
Check for this. I'm going to send an envelope when I'm going to put you some more stuff. I dig some more shit, Bill. You cannot believe it.
Oh, I believe it.
We have to make a newsletter. We're working on it. And Jesus Christ, anyhow. That's the reason I called you, to let you know you've been in and out.
Okay.
Okay?
Yep.